I recently had the opportunity to talk with a Ukrainian unit using FPV UAVs, so first-person view UAVs, in the present Ukrainian-Russian conflict. Known as Angry Birds, yes, that is their name. This is one of the many Ukrainian drone units that are partially supported by a foundation that also provides humanitarian assistance. We have all seen the footage from UAVs dropping grenades to conducting reconnaissance and artillery spotting, and initially also a lot of footage from RPAs like Bayraktar. But the use of FPV drones is less well known, which makes this really interesting. It's a very distinct system, especially because these FPV drones are in fact DIY products. They are built in a small workshop. So I sat down with Andrii from the charitable foundation Heroes Ukraine and Borys from the Angry Bird unit to talk more about the use of the system and their own brand of FPV drone.
You introduce yourself and your unit.
I'm from Angry Bird Squadron. Now we are in Navy Forces of Ukraine. And we have people from Special Forces, someone from Infantry, someone from the National Guard.
And what sort of drone are you using?
I'm FPV pilot, and one of drones that we use are FPV drones. FPV quads.
How do you use it? Like, how do you control it?
Just simple goggles, FPV goggles, and simple radio. Nothing special, only consumer parts, analog video. Everybody can make it.
So basically, you have first-person goggles on, like virtual reality, and you have a controller that is reminiscent of what you would use for, I guess, gaming. Maybe is that sort of a controller?
No. It's controller for some hobby planes controllers like this. Not a gamer controller, of course. It has sticks like with feedback.
And then you have just a radio link for the
Yes, simple radio link, consumer radio, consumer parts, nothing special. That's everybody can make it. It's not a secret one, it's not a problem to make it.
When you are going out there, I mean, what do you use this drone for? Does it have like a payload on it?
For ammunition, we use an RKG-3. You must understand, it's a DIY thing, self-made thing, so you haven't got the ammunition that the country give you, the Ministry of Defense give you, so we must adapt. And I know the guys from National Guard that used to using C4 last night on this type of drones. I know the guys from infantry that using the self-made from MK-17. It's like what you find that you can use. I can find RKG-3.
And what are your targets then with this munition?
Light armored vehicles, BRDM, MTLB, sometimes generators, sometimes the anti-drone guns, portable, they have.
And when you go out there, do you do this alone? Do you work in combination with other forces like artillery, infantry, tanks, or is this you just finding your target and then neutralizing it?
No, not only one, because it's it's a madness. We are working with recognition, because without good recognition, I couldn't find my target, because FPV, we using analog video on FPV, and it's so. I couldn't find the target by myself. So we using other consumer drones like Mavics, Matrix.
So you have somebody telling you where the target is, guiding you to the approximate location, and then once you're close enough, you take over and...
Yep.
Talk me through a mission. We already touched upon some of these things, but talk me through a mission. Like, you're going out there. What are the sort of the steps you do in order to then prepare and then also fulfill the mission?
The first one is planning. Without plan, I wouldn't go. Then recognition, I know what, then planning my flight, because when you plan your flight, you must know the direction of wind, the strength of wind, what's the weather, because you have a battery on your drone, and if you wouldn't know about this, that the wind will on you.
It will drain the battery, yep, right? Yep. And then, so you've done your planning, you know sort of the wind, and then what happens afterwards?
I just made my work. I of course, I go with infantry, because I couldn't watch about what is happening when I'm flying, and of course with the guys who know about the mines, the field, what is there.
Right, they have local knowledge and they can tell you
where
to set up. Okay, and what sort of lessons have you learned as you have been going through these missions?
Be patient. Don't make something fast, because it will bring your problems, and you will just fail. It's like, I think it's some kind of snipe work. Then you must be patient.
So you wait for the best moment and then.
Yep.
And what sort of, I mean, you've been using this drone, I imagine, for quite a while now. And have you seen any sort of reaction on the Russian side? Do they have any countermeasures to it?
Of course. They're using the mesh. For your understanding, they are also using this type of drones because it's a consumer one. And so we are using meshes, and they're using the electric warfare. Sometimes don't. But the most problem for now is meshes.
So it's just you're not able to like get to the armor of the vehicle.
Yep. I couldn't see it because I have a low resolution and I just don't see it.
How do you get around that? Like, do you have with your reconnaissance drones, do you have like an ability to get close enough to see if a vehicle has those defenses?
Sometimes you couldn't see it even from Mavic or from Matris. It's just like so tiny, so small that sometimes shit happens.
Have you like learned to adapt to that, or is this something you just cannot account for?
For now, I couldn't. It just happened and shit happens. Okay.
And how many sort of, I don't know if you can tell me this, but how many sort of vehicles have you destroyed at this point?
For now, I couldn't tell, because you can see, if you were watching about the war, you can see, like, for about the last 4 or 5 weeks, so much FPV drones used in Bakhmut. And... the guys are using them for about 6 drones a day. You can count. About 70% of data. 70%.
So 70% success rate.
Yeah.
Okay. And do you find this is then more effective than other types of drones that like drop grenades?
As you can see, it's not more effective, it's the other thing. You can eliminate light armored, but you couldn't eliminate light armored with Mavic. But with Mavic you have a better view. You can just help artillery and other. You must adapt to the war and understand that every type of drone can be used. Every type.
Sort of, if you were to make any sort of changes to the drone that you're using right now, what would be the change that you would like to see?
The most thing I want to do is to build FPV plane, not a quad FPV plane, because I understand that FPV planes have a better battery capacity, because you don't using 4 motors, you're using just 1, you have a wing, and you can just fly further and further and eliminate targets on the range, like 12 kilometers.
And is that not a bit more difficult to fly as well?
I don't know how it's more difficult to fly on the plane between quad, but in quad you must have some skills to fly. It's really a skill one. So 30 hours on simulator, and then only then you can just try to fly on a real drone.
Okay, so you train first on a simulator before you actually.
Of course. Yeah. Yes.
And what would you say are sort of the advantages and the disadvantage of the quadcopter that you have?
The advantages: it is really fast. It is maneuver. And the disadvantages, it has the small capacity of battery and small capacity of ammunition. No, 700 grams, it's like nothing.
It's I assume it's good enough for the targets that you have currently, but if you were to expand to a plane,
but more wide, better. If I would use planes, it will be more wide.
How is it then for sourcing all these components? I mean, you said that this is like civilian components, but you also have to then get like the munitions from the military, right? And how do you sort of go about sourcing these things?
Parts for drones are given by a foundation, Heroes of Ukraine, and the ammunition give me the Ministry of Defense and my commanders. But then you must adapt it, make DIY things, and then it's not a problem. In effect, the guys are using aluminium from cans to make propellers for bombs, like from the World War II when it's fly down. Yeah, it's just spin out and it works. You can adapt everything.
And who had sort of the idea to build this, and why build it the way you have built it?
I don't know who has the idea, because it's a consumer thing. When I was a civilian, I was working in video production, and we were using such kind of drones for videos. And I thought that it can carry GoPro. Why it couldn't carry some more light?
So you already had the experience, and then it was easy to sort of translate that into your present.
Yep.
And do you know sort of how long the testing period was for this drone, whether it works, and sort of to iron out the kinks?
If you know what to do, the testing period will be like about week or two.
Do you have any sort of challenges in making it? I mean, I understand you have civilian components, military components, and you're sourcing those, and that doesn't appear to be an issue. But do you have any sort of challenges of making them at scale, like a lot of them?
Yes, but I wouldn't tell you what's when you're trying to make it cheaper. Some parts that are maybe 3D printed, and here's become a problem. And I know the guys who tried it and have a problems. If you making everything from instruction from internet, you wouldn't have a problem. If you're trying to make it cheaper and make some parts DIY, you would have a problems.
And do you know sort of what improvements have been made since like the first prototype to what you have now?
Nothing. It's only DIY antennas and some things in frame. That's all.
And how much does it cost to build one of them?
I think if I was a Russian, I would say about $1,000, or maybe even more, $2,000. God bless the corruption in Russian army, because they also making this type of drones, and Dobrynya 5 it's called, and there is production in Russia, but in fact it's the Chinese one, Nazgul 5, that it costs about $400, and they're reselling it for about $2,000. And like watching on this, and God bless corruption. In fact, it the difference in cost from $500 to $700. Sometimes you couldn't find components for it, and the prices are higher. Sometimes you can find it cheaper. So in this range.
And you said that the Russians are, of course, also using this type of drone.
Yep.
Do you find that they are as effective as you are? Are they less effective? Are you learning something from them? Are you like telling your own forces how to defend against these type of drones?
I know they have a lot of schools now in Russia that are studying to how to fly in FPV drones. They have a complex studying of DJI Mavics, FPV drones, DIY drones, planes, and I think it will be a problem in a half a year, maybe a year. But in fact, what I see, what the Ministry of Defense are telling, they made it wouldn't be a problem, because it's up like 200 grams.
So it's a way lower yield than the one that you're having then. And are there any plans to sort of expand your unit? I mean, you're like a semi-civilian military unit, if I understand that correctly.
Yeah, some engineers are civilians, some guys are military one. That's the situation for now.
Yeah, Andrei, do you want to talk a little bit more about sort of the unit then, and how it finances itself?
There was a charity fund here as Ukraine made just for supporting our unit. We have a humanitarian aid project called Civilians Under Attack. We may attach the link for it, like tactical medicine for civilians, also first aid kits purchasing, and there is also one more option to help us win this war. We're cooperating with the Khymych Foundation. It is a non-profit organization by the name of Yuri Khymych. He is one of the most famous Ukrainian painting artists. It was made to be a museum with his works collection, but now we have war, so we reached the guys and they told us that they can help us. They may sell some works, some masterpieces, and all the money we earn, we will spend on our unit needs. So if you want to help us, you may buy a masterpiece or just directly donate to our humanitarian project.
Thank you. I'll put those in the description below those links. Thank you very much for answering the questions, and I wish you all the best.